Question number 9. In the 1908 Olympic Games, the Olympic marathon was lengthened from 40 kilometers to approximately 42 kilometers. Of the following, which is closest to the increase in the distance of the Olympic marathon in miles? So 1 mile is approximately 1.6 kilometers. So how much you increase from 40 to 42? Means it increases by 2 kilometers. So 1 mile is 1.6 kilometer. So 2 kilometers will be how many miles? Okay. So it's like this. Kilometers and miles. This is better way of doing it. 1 miles shows 1.6 kilometers. Okay. But here 2 kilometers means how many miles? Of course, it means more miles than one. Okay. So you can cross them and x is times 1.6 is equal to 2 times 1 is 2. So that will be 2 divided by 1.6. So 2 divided by 1.6 is, that will be 1.25. The answer here is 1.25 miles. That's B. Okay? That was an easy question. We needed to just convert from miles to kilometers. 10 questions. The density d of an object is found by dividing the mass of the object by its volume. So d is equal to mass divided by volume. Which of the following equations gives the mass in terms of d and v? So you multiply both sides by v, you will get dv is equal to m. So that's all. Mass in terms of d and v is dv, m is equal to dv. That's all. This is option A. Okay. Now question number 11 is, this negative 2x plus 3y is equal to 6 is an equation, a linear equation is given. In the xy plane, the graph of which of the following equations is perpendicular to the graph of the equation above? All right, when two lines are perpendicular, like this line is perpendicular to this line, L1, L2, the slope of both these lines is negative reciprocal of each other. Like if this, the slope of this line is 2 over 3, this should be negative 3 over 2. If this is 5 over 4, this should be minus 4 over 5. So when you multiply these two slopes, you will get negative 1. So this is important that the slope of one is negative reciprocal of slope of other. Okay, so 4, 5 upon 4 and minus 4 upon 5 are negative reciprocals of each other. Minus 3 upon 2 and 2 upon 3 are negative reciprocals of each other. Okay, so we need to find out the slopes of both of these, all of these lines. So the best way of finding out the slope when these are written in this form, ax plus by is equal to constant, these equations must be written in this form first. Only then I can use this formula what I'm going to tell you. The slope is m, or the slope, negative coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y. Okay, so here what is the coefficient of x? Negative 2, and coefficient of y? 3. So the slope of the given line is minus coefficient of x minus 2. This minus is just in the formula, over coefficient of y is 3. The slope is 2 upon 3 for the given line, this line, 2 upon 3. Write it here. Okay, Now, the slope of one of these lines should be negative reciprocal of this 2 upon 3. That is minus 3 upon 3. It should be minus 3 upon 2. So, which line will give you minus 3 upon 2? We have to see. So, let's try these individually. So, negative here. Yeah. Quotient of x 3 and quotient of y 2. Yeah. That's it. Minus 3.2. We need minus 3.2. What about the others? This is minus 3 upon 4. And this is minus 2 upon 4. And this is minus 2.6. So none of these three is equal to minus 3.2. So the slope of this line is 2.3 and slope of this A part line is minus 3.2. So both are negative reciprocals of each other. Another method of finding the slope is to convert these equations into slope-intercept form. Y is equal to mx plus c. Let me tell you that method too, okay? So this equation is given minus 2x plus 3y is equal to 6. So 3y is equal to 2x plus 6 and y is equal to 2x over 3 plus 6 over 3. So the equation becomes 2 over 3x plus 2. If you compare it with y is equal to mx plus c, you will see that the slope is 2 over 3. Now from the options, one of the equation must have the negative reciprocal slope. So that's, I told you, I took the first equation first, that is 3x plus 2y is equal to 6. 3x plus 2y is equal to 6. What we need the negative reciprocal of this. Negative reciprocal. There should be minus 3 over it. So what is the slope here? Let's see. 2y is equal to, take it there, minus 3x plus 6. Divide by 2 on both sides, that will be minus 3x over 2 and plus 6 over 2. So y is equal to minus 3 over 2x plus 3. You don't need to see this constant value because 2 it is 3, 5. You just need to see this. That whether this is negative reciprocal of this or not. So yes, this is negative reciprocal of this. So that's why I chose option A. If you want to try on other three, you can, but this method is longer than what I told you earlier. So using this method, you'll be better off and you'll be able to solve faster. But for that, you need to memorize this formula that if the equation is written in this form, x plus 3y is equal to c, then quotient of x, negative quotient of x upon coefficient of y is the slope actually. Okay, so if you want to memorize this shortcut, memorize it in its entirety. Like, do not forget to write even this minus here, or do not forget to write x here and y here. Sometimes people make the mistake of writing y here and x here. So be very careful with these things. Okay, all right. So question 13 says, which of the following the ordered pairs xy satisfies the system of inequalities above? So the inequalities are given. Let's move to here. Y less than equal to 3x plus 1. And the second one is x minus y greater than 1. Okay. What's the first option? Minus 2 minus 1. Minus 2 minus 1. If we put minus 2 minus 1 in here, x minus 2 y minus 1, both sides should be same. Or if you put minus 2 in x, you should get y minus 1. Okay, equal to. So, if I put negative 2 here, that will give me 3 times negative 2 plus 1, negative 5, negative 6 plus 1, that is negative 5. But it should have been minus 1. So this point does not solve it. Okay, so this is the wrong point. Let's assume the next point. That is minus 1, 3. Minus 1, 3. Let's put this minus 1 here. 3 times minus 1 plus 1 minus 2. Minus 3 plus 1, that's minus 2. But it should be 3. So that's not satisfying it either. Okay? So we will see that whether it's. We also can see less than. First, we'll see that whether it's equal to or not. Then, if it doesn't satisfy, we'll move to the less than one again. Okay? So the other point, third point is 1, 5. 1, 5. Put 1 here. 3, 1 plus 1. 3 and 1, 4. Okay? And y is 5. 5 is not less than 4. So, what you can do is you can put the value minus 1 here too. So, what you can do is minus 1 less than equal to, just a sec. So, minus 1 less than equal to minus 1 less than equal to minus 5. So, this is wrong. Okay, absolutely. So, let me do that here too. So, y is 3. Less than equal to minus 2? No. So this again not true. So now we are testing the third point, 1, 5. So I am also writing 5, 5 here. 5 less than equal to 3, 1 plus 1. So 5 less than equal to 4? No, it's not. So now we are left with the fourth point. That is 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1. So x is 2, y is minus 1. Minus 1 less than equal to 3x plus 1. Minus 1 less than equal to 6 plus 1. 7. Yes, minus 1 is less than 7. So this is true here. Let's check it out for the second x minus y greater than equal to 1. So x is 2, y is minus 1. 2 plus 1, 3 greater than 1. Boom. So this last point satisfies this one. Both the equations. The first one and the second one. If I put 2 minus 1 in here, 2 here, minus 1 here, like this, so minus 1 is less than 7. And if I put 2 and minus 1 here, 2 here and minus 1 here, I get 3 greater than 1. So both equations are being satisfied using this fourth point. Okay? So the answer to this is this fourth point, B. Okay?